Hello and welcome to my class. As you know, we have completed 3 chapters of Hamara Bharat, class 4th. Today we will begin with new chapter, that is Rivers of India and their plains. India is a very big country with many rivers. Some are large and some are small. So, being rich with many rivers, India is rightly called country of rivers. These rivers originate from high reaches of mountain by melting of ice, glaciers and from rainwater. On the basis of quality and nature, there are 2 types of rivers. These are perennial rivers and seasonal rivers. First, we will talk of perennial rivers. These rivers originate from melting of ice in mountains and have water round the year. Ganga, Yamuna and Satluj are examples of perennial rivers. Seasonal rivers, as it is clear from its name. These rivers also originate from mountains, but they have less water or have water during rainy season only. That's why they are called seasonal rivers. Chambal, Betwa, Krishna, Kaveri, Narmada and Tapti are rivers of this category. Students, as you see in this picture, the Himalayan mountain range is in north of India. A mountain range means many mountains one after another in a row. The Himalayan mountain range is very extensive. I want to tell you that word Himalaya comes from Sanskrit. Word Him and Ale. Him means ice and Ale means home. So it makes home of ice. Mountains are not only beautiful, but they are very useful for us. Many rivers originate from Himalaya and its glaciers like Ganga, Yamuna, Satluj, Ravi and Jhelum. Glaciers are defined as huge deposits of ice on the peaks of mountains. Students, you must know that Ganga originates from Gomukh at Gangotri and Yamuna from Yamunotri glaciers. Let's talk about journey of river now. The journey of a river starts from mountains with very high flow. You know why? Because mountains have slope. But as river comes down towards plains, it speeds gradually slows down. Because plains are flatter than mountains. During this journey, rivers make the soil fertile on the banks due to the dead and decayed plants brought with it. A river passes through many countries, cities and villages during its journey. One such example is River Indus. It flows through India and Pakistan. As you see in the picture, the journey of a river starts from mountain and finishes in some lake or sea. Many famous cities are situated on the bank of River Ganga. These are Haridwar, Kanpur, Allahabad, Patna and Kolkata. Similarly, our capital Delhi is situated on the bank of River Yamuna. Other cities on this bank are Agra, Mathura and Yamuna Nagar. Rivers play an important role in making and formation of plains. These plains are made up with soil brought by rivers. Northern plains of India are the best example of it. You must know that northern plains of Haryana, Punjab, Uttar Pradesh and Patna are flat and fertile due to the soil brought by rivers. These rivers are Indus, Ganga and their tributaries. These plains are most suitable places for farmers. Now, we will talk about main rivers of South India. Here we see major rivers of South India. These are Krishna, Kaveri, Godavari, Mahanadi, Narmada and Tapti. Godavari is the largest river of South India. Now we will talk about the importance of river. Let's see why rivers are important for us. They bring new and fertile soil for crops. Hydroelectricity is generated with their water. They help in irrigation, provide chance for livelihood like fishing, etc. And most importantly, these rivers are a source of drinking water and basic daily needs. While talking about importance of rivers, how can we forget about Punjab, the most prosperous state of Northern Plains? The name of Punjab means a land of five rivers. Punjab is driven from Persian word panj and ab. Panj means five, while ab means water. The five rivers of Punjab are Ravi, Bias, Jhelum, Chenab and Satluj. Punjab has many reasons for its prosperity. It is blessed with flat plains and fertile soil, good irrigation system, high level of underground water, new method and technology in farming system. Let's not forget that at one point of time, excess use of fertilizers had bad effect on soil and made it marshy and infertile. Here we see the image of Bhakra Nangal Dam, which is built on River Satluj. This dam proved to be a boon for farmers of Punjab. It provides with electricity and water for irrigation. Main festivals of Punjab are Lohri, Baisakhi and Guru Purab. While talking about Punjab, we cannot miss the vibrance and liveliness of dances of Punjab. Bhangra dance by boys in their colorful lungis and kurtas, and Gidda dance in beautiful attires by girls on the beat of dhol can't stop you from dancing with them. Another famous and important place of Punjab is Golden Temple in Amritsar. It is a holy place for Sikhs. So, students, this was the chapter Rivers of India and Their Plains. Now, here is some work for you. You have to complete these worksheets to check your knowledge. We will meet you with another chapter next week. Till then, take care, stay home, stay safe. Bye-bye.